Welcome to Gartex channel. Today we shall discuss about voltage regulators and power supply. Power supplies are an important element in many electronics equipments. While some are battery driven, others need mains power supplies, and the power supply electronic circuitry and design is of utmost importance to the successful operation of the whole equipment. There are three main types of power supply that can be used. Each have their own advantages and disadvantages, and as a result, each is used under slightly different circumstances. The three major types of electronics power supply are 1. Rectified and smoothed power supply. These electronics power supplies are the simplest types, and are generally used for non-critical applications where performance is not a major issue. This type of power supply was widely used in thermionic valve or vacuum tube equipment as it was not so easy to regulate supplies, and often the requirements were not so critical. 2. Linear regulated power supply. This form of electronics power supply is able to provide a very high level of performance. Conversely, the fact that it uses a series regulator element means that it can be comparatively inefficient, dissipating a significant proportion of the input power as heat. However, these power supplies can offer very high levels of regulation with low values of ripple, etc. 3. Switch mode power supply, SMP. In this form of power supply, electronic circuits use switching technology to regulate the output. Although spikes are present on the output, they offer very high levels of efficiency, and in view of this, they can be contained in much smaller packages than their linear equivalents. A power supply can be split into a number of elements, each providing a function within the overall power supply, and they include the following. 1. Power input filtering. In some cases, it is necessary to ensure that spikes from the power line do not enter the power supply, and that noise that might be generated by the power supply does not enter the power lines. To achieve this, a circuitry to remove noise and limit the effects of incoming spikes is placed at the input to the power supply. In many cases, any filtering at this point is quite minimal, although for specialist supplies, more complex circuits may be used. 2. Input transformer. If a power supply using mains supplies of 110 volts or 240 volts AC is used, then the input usually has a transformer to transform the incoming line voltage to required level for the power supply design. 3. A rectifier. It is necessary to change the incoming AC waveform to a DC waveform. This is achieved using an AC rectifier circuit. Two types of rectifier circuit may be used: full wave and half wave rectifiers. 4. A smoothing rectifier. The output from the AC rectifier circuit consists of a waveform varying from 0 volts to 1.414 times the root mean square input voltage. For this voltage to be used by electronic circuits, it needs to be smoothed. This is achieved using a capacitor. It will charge up over part of the cycle, and then as the voltage falls, it will supply the current to the circuit, charging up again as the voltage rises. 5. Voltage regulation. Even after the rectified voltage has been smoothed, there may still be significant levels of residual hum. Also, the voltage will vary as different levels of current are drawn. To provide a stable voltage output from the power supply with little residual hum and noise, a voltage regulator circuit is required. Regulators are able to provide a stable voltage at a set or variable level dependent upon the requirement. This may use either linear or switching mode techniques to bring the output voltage to the required level. 6. Overvoltage protection. In the event of the failure of the regulator, it is possible under some circumstances that the output voltage from the power supply could rise to a level that could damage the circuitry being powered. To prevent this occurrence, overvoltage protection circuitry can be used. This circuit element detects the level of the output voltage, and if it starts to rise above its acceptable limits, it will trip, removing the supply from the regulator and usually clamping the output from the regulator to 0 volts, thereby protecting the remaining circuitry from damage. Electronic devices are usually made up of diverse electronic components that sometimes operate at different voltage levels. To reliably meet the power requirements of a particular design or that of different components within the design, Voltage regulators are usually employed in the power supply unit to regulate the voltage at the main source to what is needed across different sections of the device. For instance, in any working circuit system like a smartphone, wristwatch, computer, or laptop, the power supply is an essential part of the system, because it provides steady, reliable, and continuous supply to the inside components of the system. In electronic devices, the power supply provides a stable as well as regulated power to enable the circuits work properly. There are two types of power sources, namely, the AC power supply that we get from the mains outlets and the DC power supply that we get from the batteries. So, in this tutorial, we are going to discuss an overview of different types of voltage regulators and their working. What is a voltage regulator? A voltage regulator is a semiconductor device that is used to regulate voltage levels. When a steady, reliable voltage is needed, then the voltage regulator is the preferred device. The voltage regulator generates a fixed output voltage that remains constant for any changes in an input voltage or load conditions. It acts as a buffer for protecting components from damages. A voltage regulator is a device with a simple feed-forward design and it uses negative feedback control loops. How many types of voltage regulators are available in the market today? There are mainly two types of voltage regulators. 1. Linear voltage regulators. 2. Switching voltage regulators. The linear voltage regulator is the easiest type of voltage regulator. It is available in two types, which are compact and used in low power, low voltage systems. The main components used in the voltage regulator are 1. Feedback circuit. 2. Stable reference voltage. 3. Pass element control circuit. The voltage regulation process is very easy by using the above three components. The first component of the voltage regulator, like a feedback circuit, is used to detect the changes within the DC voltage output. Based on the reference voltage as well as feedback, a control signal can be generated and drives the pass element to compensate the changes. Here, pass element is one kind of solid-state semiconductor device similar to a BJT transistor, PN junction diode, otherwise a MOSFET. Now, the DC output voltage can be maintained approximately stable. These voltage regulators are mainly used to regulate the voltage of a system. However, linear voltage regulators work with low efficiency while switching regulators work with high efficiency. In switching regulators with high efficiency, most of the input power can be transmitted to the output without dissipation. There are two types of linear voltage regulators: series linear voltage regulators and parallel or shunt linear voltage regulators. There are three types of switching voltage regulators: step up, step down, and inverter voltage regulators. Let us discuss linear voltage regulators in details. Linear voltage regulators use the principles of voltage dividers to transform the voltage at their input to the desired voltage at their output. They employ a feedback loop that automatically varies the resistance in the system to counter the effect of variations in the load impedance and input voltage, all to ensure the output voltage is kept constant. If the voltage across the load is tending to fall too low, then this will be detected. The control voltage for the series element will then cause the conductance of the series element to rise and the voltage across the load will be maintained. This is a typical form of negative feedback system. The control voltage must have a reference against which the output can be compared. This is often provided by a voltage reference circuit based around a Zener diode. The output voltage from the regulator is taken, often through a potential divider, and compared with the reference voltage, and the error voltage is fed back as the control voltage to alter the conductance of the series control element. It is possible to vary the output voltage by changing the amount by which the output is divided down. By placing a variable resistor in the potential divider, the voltage that is compared with the reference voltage can be changed. This in turn will change the output voltage from the voltage regulator circuit. Typical implementations of linear voltage regulators involve the use of field effect transistors as one side of a voltage divider with a feedback loop connected to the gate of the transistor, driving it as required to ensure consistency in the output voltage. While this use of transistors as resistors helps simplify the design and implementation of linear regulators, it contributes largely to the inefficiency associated with the regulators. The reason for this is that the transistors convert the excess electrical energy to heat, leading to power loss as a result of heating in the transistors. In situations where the voltage at the input or the load current at the output is too high, the regulators could generate heat levels that may lead to its breakdown. To moderate this, designers usually employ heat sinks whose size is determined by the amount of current to be drawn through the regulator. Another point worth talking about for linear regulators is the need for the voltage at the input to be greater than the voltage at the output by a minimum value called the dropout voltage. This voltage value, which is usually around 2 volts, varies between regulators and is sometimes a major source of concern for designers working on low power applications due to power loss. To overcome this, use a type of linear voltage regulators called low dropout LDO regulators, as they are designed with the ability to function with as low as 100 millivolts difference between the input and output voltage. A series voltage regulator uses a variable element placed in series with the load. By changing the resistance of that series element, the voltage dropped across it can be changed. And the voltage across the load remains constant. The amount of current drawn is effectively used by the load. This is the main advantage of the series voltage regulator. Even when the load does not require any current, the series regulator does not draw full current. Therefore, a series regulator is considerably more efficient than a shunt voltage regulator. A shunt voltage regulator works by providing a path from the supply voltage to the ground through a variable resistance. The current through the shunt regulator is diverted away from the load and flows uselessly to the ground, making this form usually less efficient than the series regulator. It is, however, simpler, sometimes consisting of just a voltage reference diode, and is used in very low-powered circuits wherein the wasted current is too small to be of concern. This form is very common for voltage reference circuits. These circuits use a series resistor to provide a current-limiting action, and Zener diode is placed between the resistor and ground in parallel with the load. As the Zener diode maintains a constant voltage, and variations in current by the load will not cause any significant voltage variations because the diode will maintain a constant voltage, taking up any current variations. Shunt regulators are used in low output voltage switching power supplies, current source and sink circuits, error amplifiers, adjustable voltage or current linear and switching power supplies, analog and digital circuits that require precision references, precision current limiters, etc. There are several standard voltage levels that your circuit design might require. 3.3 volts DC. This is a common voltage used by Raspberry Pi and low-powered digital devices. 5 volts DC. This is the standard transistor-transistor logic (TTL) voltage used by digital devices. 12 volts DC used for DC, servo and stepper motors. 24 volts or 48 volts DC, widely used in CNC and 3D print projects. The voltage drop in the linear regulator is proportional to the dissipated power or heat of the IC. For the power dissipation in the linear regulators, following equation can be used. Power equals input voltage minus output voltage, multiplied by current. The L7805 linear regulator has to dissipate at least 2 watts if it would deliver a 1 ampere load, 2V times 1 ampere. The next important parameter is the thermal resistance in units of degree Celsius per watt. This indicates the number of degrees the chip will heat up above the ambient air temperature per each watt of power it must dissipate. Simply multiply the calculated power dissipation by thermal resistance, and that will tell you how much that linear regulator will heat up under that amount of power. Power times thermal resistance equals temperature above ambient. For example, a LM7805 regulator has a thermal resistance of 50 degrees Celsius per watt. This means if your regulator is dissipating 1 watt, it will heat up 50 degrees Celsius. 2 watts, it will heat up 100 degrees Celsius. Efficiency calculation. Efficiency is calculated using this formula. Efficiency equals output voltage divided by input voltage. For example, 12 volts on the input and need to output 5 volts at 1 ampere of load current, then the efficiency for a linear regulator would only be 5V divided by 12 volts times 100% equals 41%. This means that only 41% of the power from the input is transferred to the output, and the remaining power will be lost as heat.
Thank you for watching this tutorial. Please like, comment, share and subscribe to this channel for more video updates. Bye.